or a human being, but I haven't done anything wrong.
Nothing wrong, nothing wrong, he tells me.
Do you know what time it is?
No.
Well, you should. It is exactly 7 minutes past midnight, and you were supposed to be home at 12. What have you got to say about that?
On my way home, I got a flat tire. Honest.
Don't you lie to me, or I'll bring you up on charges of perjury, too.
But I...
Shut up! I've had enough of your garbage. I don't want another word out of you. You'll have your chance in court, but first, we'll hear from the prosecution. Let the trial begin.
Mom! Dad! I warned you to be quiet. One more word out of you and I'll have you bound and gagged.
This court now calls to the stand the defendant's mother, Angus Young. Mrs. Young. Now, Mrs. Young, will you please tell this court exactly what happened here tonight?
Your Honor, it was just horrible!
We understand.
Well, Your Honor, my husband and I were waiting for our son, Angus, to come home. We were just sitting in the living room waiting when the clock struck midnight.
12 o'clock then was the time the defendant was to be home?
Yes. Angus has never been late before. My husband got up and he started to pace the floor. Then it was 1 minute past 12. I called the driver where he said he was going, but they didn't know if he was there. Then, it was 2 minutes past 12. I called the police stations and hospitals, but he wasn't there either.
Then what happened, Laura?
Then, it was 3 minutes past 12, Jim. I was crazy with fear. My husband smoked a pack of cigarettes, and I started to drink.
You're in contempt of court, you despicable little piece of dirt.
Well, Your Honor, it was too horrible to get out. Then it was 4 minutes past 12. I tried to get in bed, but I couldn't sleep. I kept tossing and turning, but I couldn't get images out of my mind of my poor child, my baby, my dad, so dead.
I think we've heard enough. You may step down, Laura. Thank you. You should be ashamed of yourself putting that wonderful saint of a woman through that hell. If I were you, I'd consider suicide. This court now calls to the stand the defendant's father, Mr. Young. Mr. Young, Sam, have you ever noticed any abnormal or criminal behavior in your son, the defendant, before?
Yes, I have. Well, Your Honor, several times I've caught my son listening to rock and roll albums in his room. Why, he even has a whole collection in his closet. What's a father to do? I tell you, they play that stuff on the radio. Today's youth listen to it all the time. Why, I've heard stories of people drinking beer with the music turned up. Rebellious and downright disgraceful. It kills brain cells.
Oh, this is great. And you think this rock and roll, as they call it, is what caused your son, the defendant, to consciously rebel against a father's authority?
Yes, I do.
Thank you. You may step down.
Thank you.
This court now calls to the stand the defendant, Angus Young.
I said take the stand, you slimy earthworm!
Slug? You, punk! You are charged with a very serious criminal offense. And I have to warn you that when you're found guilty, I mean if you're found guilty, I will have no other choice but to sentence the maximum penalty under the law.
But what are the charges?
You pig, you are charged with arriving home after the agreed-upon time that your mother has testified was 12 o'clock. And you are also charged with consciously, before the fact, planning on being home late as a
rebellious statement to deny your father's authority. How do you plead?
It wasn't my fault. On my way home, I got a flat tire and it took a half an hour to fix. I'm innocent, I tell you.
Have you any witnesses to prove that you have this unsubstantiated flat tire?
Yes, my friends Malcolm and Bond were there too.
Malcolm and Bond? Two teenagers. He wants me to take the word of two teenagers. Friends of a disease to society like yourself. You must be mad.
A highway patrolman stopped and helped us.
A highway patrolman? It's a highway patrolman now. Next it'll be the President of the United States. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I want you to know that the defendant is a liar. He is making up fictional witnesses. He pisses me off. Sure, you probably flattened the spare before you came in. I've got enough of your garbage. I want you to get off the stand and get out of my sight. Slug. Filth. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, have you reached a verdict? For sentencing.
But I'm innocent!
Shut up! You had your chance in court. Now it's time to pay me. Angus Young, for your sentence, I think I'll have you grounded for about 1 year. Yes, 1 year. That's 12 months. And not only that, I want all your rock and roll albums out of your house and burned. And, for the topper, I think we'll have you give 10 weeks work detail at Yuba City High with my very good and very short friend, Mr. Barry, supervising. Yes, I'm afraid so. I only wish there was some way to have him taken out and done away with legally.
Don't worry, son. We'll fight this off.
What?
What behind you?
Your mother and I won't be here.
That's right. We'll take this case to Supreme Court if we have to.
But what you guys done at the trial?
We're behind you 100%. After all, we are your parents.